Hello, and welcome to another Flash game. This is Motherload, and it's a kind of mining game. You mine for resources, you get upgrades. Basically, that's how it goes. So, yeah, I used to play this game a long time ago. It was really fun. Alright, so let's begin and do a new game. And I will basically go through the game, show you any strategies about how to play and stuff, and we'll get through it. So, let's begin. New game. Alright. Oh. Mr. Natas. Oh. Alright. We forgot to your refuelio on the way over. Drive over to the fuel station, left, and fill her up. It's been almost impossible to hire decent miners on Mars since all this strange activity started happening. That's why we're willing to pay you at a premium for your services. I've given you a basic mining machine to get started with. Unfortunately, you'll be on your own from this point onward, as the settlers who were lucky enough to escape their lives have fled to safety. However, all the shops here have been computerized, so you'll still be able to sell your minerals, fuel up, upgrade, and buy special items. Remember, your job is to collect minerals and bring them back to the surface for processing. The deeper you dig, the more valuable the minerals you'll encounter. Don't forget to refuel. Good luck. Alright, thank you. Okay, so first what we're gonna do, So as you can see, you can buy fuel at different prices. So the least fuel you can get, like the less expensive price, but you can just click fill tank to fill it all up. So if we are desperate, we don't have a lot of money, we can just choose one of the other options, but I think we'll be fine. So what I like to do is kind of dig a tunnel. It's in a straight line. I'd say 2 to 3 feet wide. Yeah, so basically three wide. I like that. Okay. And let's begin. Gonna go ahead and make a tunnel. We may not get a whole lot of resources yet. As you can see, our fuel just ran out almost all the way. So you're gonna have a problem with that for a little while, but it's okay. Out of fuel again. Alright, let's go ahead and fill up. Okay. There we go. Okay, so as you can see, we are starting to run out of money. So what we can do is we can sell any minerals we collected. Oh, we don't have any. That's okay. That's okay. We'll find some on the way. Look right there. Yeah. Bit of a rocky start there, but we'll be all right. We still have fuel, all right. Okay. We're going to get, right there, that's golden. That's pretty valuable compared to the other, or you can get, like, I see the orange and gray ones are, like, the least valuable. Oh, I see. Not enough cash. Alright, let's quickly now go over here, sell some stuff. Now, if you notice, if I wait too long, it'll say fuel critical, and then you'll almost die right there, so do not let that happen. Fill tank, there we go. Okay, now we have a good amount of savings, and gotta make sure we have savings in case something happens, so. But we did nearly avoid that, so that's good. That's the important thing. Okay, got some gold in. This is a pretty valuable resource at this depth. It's like one of the rare things you can find. This is a little bit rare, maybe not as rare as gold. Silvium. There we go. Silverium. Oh. Anyways, let's go ahead and do this. Okay, so, I like having wider tunnels because what we're going to do, we can drop down a couple hundred feet. Ooh, nearly died there. Oh gosh. Oh, sorry. So, that was not a good idea, but, if we were more careful next time, we need to, like, remember exactly how much feet it was, because I gotta be careless, and I will get careless sometimes, but, yeah. Okay, fuel low. So you can see, time is everything. Timing is everything, I mean. Yes. This is quite difficult to game. Okay, so, okay, now, let's go to the other shops. I'm gonna show you quickly what they can do. So this is the upgrade shop. At the moment, you can technically upgrade something. But I think the important thing for now is probably repairing the hull, because we were not doing so well there. repair. Good, good. And it does tend to get a bit expensive sometimes. Plus, of like 100. This is, yeah. It's okay, though. So, for later on in the game, we could buy some of these fuel tanks. They're useful for going longer underground, and there's dynamite, which will come in handy later on. I'll explain later about that. And teleporters, if you're like, want to teleport back, which is a bit fancy, we're not going to be there for a while. But, so, I think our goal is to save up a little more, get about 750, and just slowly go down here. Alright, so I'll tell myself to remember next time how deep it is. Okay. It's important to get fuel tank upgrades. And of course other upgrades too, but it is quite helpful to get fuel tank upgrades first. Since we'll be down for quite a while. So 750, okay. Make sure to still have some more left over. Good. Alright, and if you want to, you can go up there to save the game, but we're not going to. We're going to go through the whole game, so. And I think we already went here. Alright, so about 300, 400. Yeah, about 300 or 400, I think. Still haven't found that much yet. There will be some other things along the way, other minerals and stuff. The deeper you go. Oh! From Mr. Notus. Good, I see you're adapting well to the marshy soil. Here's a little something to help you on your way. Oh, what could it be? Oh wow, some extra money. Well, thank you so much. Isn't he nice? Alright, well. And, okay. Little tank. Good, good. Okay. And nothing to sell yet. That's alright. We just have savings, so it's all good. Okay. Carefully. Ooh, slow down. Right before 500. Okay, there we go. Alright. And yeah, another thing, the deeper we go, then the more obstacles will be in the way. The first thing we will encounter, not too soon, but eventually, will be some rocks in the way, and you can't not mine through the rocks. You have to, like, use explosives, which we'll get to later. But first thing we need to do is mine around them, since explosives are a bit expensive, so let's get some more fuel. Okay. Alright. Anything we have? Oh, a little bit. Oh yeah, and occasionally, something else to look out for, which is throughout the game, even early on, I suppose, are earthquakes, which will cause the ground to move around and stuff, so when you go back down again, let's go back up real quick. So when you go back down again, there's after an earthquake, say, then you have to mine through the ground again. It's not going to be, like, completely back to where it was. It's going to be kind of randomized, like, just dirt all over the place. It's a mess. So for the earthquakes, though, I think we're good. And, you know, if there was an earthquake, worst case scenario, we will have some savings so we can still buy fuel if we need to. Let's go ahead and see what the price of upgrades are. I don't think we have enough yet, but maybe. It's 2,000. We're not there yet, but soon we can get a fuel tank upgrade and go mining a little longer. So, let's say about 600 feet, was it? 500. Okay. 600. Okay, we're a little off. It was actually 700, but close enough. Okay. There we go. Okay. Not much today, that's alright. Okay. So everything's good. We are doing well. We aren't doing anything careless now with the hole. If the hole is good, our health. Oh. That's a Goldian right down there. That's very nice. I think it may have got one before, I'm not sure, but that is quite rare at this depth. I think it's more common later on. I think at the moment I don't see a whole lot around here, so. We will be finding more of that soon, I believe. Let's refuel. Okay. And go drop off some things. Okay. There we go. Not enough for fuel take upgrade yet. Let's keep going. And so later on, we do run into those rocks in the ground. We do mine around them. I say generally still try to go in a straight line, even if it's kind of branching off a little. But eventually, it's okay to branch off a lot if you have a lot of extra fuel, maybe some fuel tanks, to kind of explore a bit. I don't know. Look for some more treasure. Okay, let's go back up 980. Okay. Almost at 1,000, which is quite nice. That's quite a lot of progress so far. Okay. So, I'm not as many, but that's okay. Slowly but surely, we're making progress. And that's good. Okay, careful, careful, careful. Okay. Woo! Oh man. That's why I try to be careful, because, just simple mistakes. Okay. A transmission. From Mr. Natas, congratulations on reaching 1,000 feet of audio boost for your excellent work. Oh, thank you. We're picking up some heavy vibrations from the planet core. They seem to be causing some earthquakes. Earthquakes. I think I believe I explained that one. They also seem to be causing some garbled and misdirected transmissions. Just ignore them. Keep up the good work. Okay, thank you. Alright, we have enough for a fuel tank upgrade. Nice. Fuel tank, okay. Alright. Go ahead and sell whatever we have. Okay. There we go. You know what? Actually, let's go to fuel tank. Could get this, or I could jump to this $5,000 one, which I think I'd like to do. I know we do have some damage in the hole, but let's go ahead and see if we get any little repairs. There we go. We're fully repaired. Good, good. Yeah, just enough for some more gas, I think, if we wanted to go back. So. Alright. Alright, careful, so 1,000. Just gonna slow down. Slow down. Okay. Here we go. And just about there. There we go. Good, okay. And, as you may have noticed now, it does get a bit more difficult to mine when you get a lower depths. Dinosaur bones, I love those. Let's get that. And yeah, so I think what I was saying is that we do need a troll upgrade eventually, so we will do that soon. Mine straight through it. Yeah, I don't think that people would actually mine straight through dinosaur bones. It would, like, you know, it's just a video game, though. It's just, it's kind of funny, though. Yeah. Alright, 1,000. Nice. Maybe we can get like one more upgrade if we want. Might go back. Could do that. Perhaps. Give me a drill upgrade. That might be helpful. Okay. Oh, cargo bay full. Okay, let's go back. Say about 1,100, I think. Yeah. Okay. Over here. Okay. Fill tank. Good, good. Alright. And I'll drop off some of this. Ooh! Goldium was quite a lot of money. Okay. So, let's see. Could get some small upgrades here and there. That'd be nice. Alright. Got a Sylvite drill. Sure. Engine, radiator. Radiator costs a lot. I don't know if I want to get that yet. Let's get a better engine too. Get the mine a little further. There we go. Alright. Alright, 1,100. Careful. There we go. Alright. I do see the golden over there. We could get, but I'm focusing on the tunnel right now. So, I know there's more valuable stuff the deeper we go, so we're gonna focus on that too. But another thing, after the rocks, much greater depths, we don't have to worry about this right now, but there will be like lava and gas clouds and all sorts of things. Well, just lava and gas clouds. I don't know if there's anything else, but like, but yeah. So lava is something you can visibly see. You can run into it. Like, it's easy to avoid that. On the other hand, gas clouds are invisible, so if you run into those, the game will warn you about when you'll start running into gas pockets, so you'll be warned about it. It's okay, so you don't have to worry about that for quite a while, though, so keep that in mind. But we'll have to upgrade quite a bit of, like, our damage resistance, I think. I'll go over that, actually. Let me go ahead and tell you about that. So once there are gas pockets and stuff, you're going to need to upgrade. I'd say upgrade your hull. That, like, helps a lot with damage reduction. What else? Radiator. This is one thing that is specific to, I think, is it the lava or something? But that does help a lot, like, so you don't die from lava. Maybe also gas pockets. I'd say upgrade to it at the minimum the dual turbines. I think that's the one that's referred to. Then eventually upgrade that and that, of course. So, those are pretty important though. And another thing, if you do take damage, there's a way to repair yourself. This costs quite a lot, but eventually we can afford a few of these. That will help you repair the hull, so in case you do take damage. So. Alright, so we went over that. Hopefully for later on. Okay, so that's not too much of a surprise. Okay. Ooh, we're almost at 1,500 feet. That's quite nice. Okay. Let's go ahead and get the goldium when we get there. I think that'd be nice. Why not? Alright. Let's move this. There we go. Getting a little sidetracked there, but I think it's worth it. It's quite nice to have that. Okay. And, I don't have enough for upgrades at the moment. I think we might want to save up some more. I do wish we could find something else, though. Oh, cargo bay full. Well, I guess we should go back in anyways. Our fuel is getting low. Okay. Let's go ahead and drop off some more things. Okay. There we go. Let's see. I don't want to keep buying upgrades all the time. I do want to kind of save up a bit, but... could make it more efficient. We did get the engine already. We could probably car away. Radiator still costs too much. Probably be able to hold a few more things. There we go. Alright, so let's continue. Okay, slow down a little bit. We're almost there. Two more feet. Okay. 1,500. Okay. Made it. Alright. I always do get a bit nervous when we drop down, like, going fast, in the tunnel. Oh! You see that over there? That's quite valuable. Okay. And there are rocks. Those are rocks right there. So, you don't really have to worry about them. They aren't gonna hurt either. Just rocks. Now, the other things I was talking about, like lava and gas pockets, they're not here yet. Don't worry. We're fine. Just gonna have to deal with these rocks for now, so what we're gonna plan on doing is generally just kind of mining around them, and ooh, some more of platinum, that's what that is. Cool, I like it. So eventually might also branch off a little bit. We're gonna kind of work on the main tunnel as well, so yeah, we can't really go through it. We do try to see. Pushing the down key doesn't work. Alright. Starting out of fuel, I think we're gonna stop right here. Ooh, look at all that gold. Well, we'll get it next time, perhaps. And yeah, while it would be more efficient using a teleporter, it costs quite a bit at this point in time, so we will in the future. I think that'd be nice.